Hold up, pimpin'. Look at this. There's a guy on a horse, like, there you go. So this is like the second time I've seen someone just like cruising down the street on a horse. Well. The Sony ZV-E10. It came out and it actually looks pretty good, especially as a vlogging camera. So we gotta talk about it. Actually, but first I need to run and print out a plane ticket because I just need to hop over to Ireland real quick. But yeah, seriously though, I do need to hop over to Ireland. Just like, it's like a one night trip. But we do have to talk about the new Sony ZV-10. ZV-E10. I think that, you know what, let me look this up real quick. ZV-E10. But yeah, we definitely have to talk about this camera just because, oh no, is it about the rain? Crap. On paper, it looks like it could be the best, like the best vlogging camera. Oh, it just stop raining, but I'm gonna give it a minute. Because man, the rain is so tricky here. Like legit, it'll rain for like 2 minutes and then stop for like five and then just like storm for like 25 minutes. So I'm gonna just give it a minute before I leave the shady area with these trees. All right, I think it's safe to continue. I think we're good. It looks legit, like from all the reviews and everything that I saw, it looks like it could be like the best vlogging camera, not only from a video quality standpoint, but just the size. Wow, it's small, super lightweight. And also one of the things I love the most about it is that you can actually change the lenses. So that's a plus. You know what, one of the things is that I love about new cameras when they come out, it seems like everybody has them except for me. And they've had it for like months just to test it and do all these amazing like things with the camera, and I'm sitting here like, where's my camera? I have to run over to Ireland real quick just to kind of help my wife out. She needs some help with some bags that she's bringing from her trip. So I'm gonna fly over to Ireland, help her with these bags, and then just come right back.
Hey, you too, thank you.
And just like that, all done. All right, quick side note, Aer Lingus, pimp it, come on. Like, who has a printer these days? I mean, for real, who has a printer? Like, look how dark it is back there. The new Sony ZV-E10, which is a bump up from the Sony ZV-1. I did think the Sony ZV-1 was actually pretty good. It was just too tight on the face. Kind of like how the Pocket 1 was. The Pocket 1 was the perfect vlogging camera, but it was just too tight on the face. With the new Sony ZV-E10, it seems like this might be right on the money. Or is it? And now, this camera comes in two colors, white and black. And also, the price is only $699, which is actually like, not gonna lie. Guys, you know me and my monies. I like to keep my money. But the price for this is actually not bad. $699 is not bad for a brand new, interchangeable, crop sensor Sony camera. That's the size of a point and shoot. So just to be real, the price isn't bad. Now, something that I did mention outside was the size. It looks like a point and shoot and it looks like it can fit in your pocket, but you would have to remove the lens. Now, most likely if you're vlogging, you won't be removing the lens. You'll probably just keep a lens on there and you probably wouldn't put this in your pocket. But with that said, the size is perfect for a vlogger. What I mean is the ZV-E10 is basically a Sony A6400, but in the body of the ZV-1. So yeah, you have the crop sensor from an A6400 in a point-and-shoot camera size. That's boss. Another reason that this might be like the best vlogging camera is for the simple fact that it has a flip-out screen. It seems like moving forward, Sony will start providing flip-out screens, because I don't know if you know, but for a long time they didn't. Like, this was like a thing. All the Sony boys would be like, yo, can we get that flip-out screen though? And Sony would just be like, nah, but what about that face tracking though? No joke, that's what they were doing. Interchangeable lenses, yes, please. That is a vlogger's dream. That's fame for vloggers, baby. Yeah, I do like the fact that you can change lenses. And now, another thing that I've been noticing with other people's reviews are the audio quality is actually really, really good. And to be real, it's definitely better than the GoPro and the Pocket 2. So definitely a plus for a vlogger. It also seems to have great autofocus, well as something called face weighting, which basically keeps the face properly exposed no matter what's going on around you. I need that. It's giving me the itch. Like, my new tech droposis is creeping back in, y'all. So did Sony do it? Did Sony make the perfect vlogging camera for us? I'ma go ahead and say not really. Only because when you look at these reviews and you look at the stabilization and that rolling shutter, woo, it's pretty bad. And now, to be real, I am a huge, huge Sony fan, but I don't know why this camera is targeted heavily towards vloggers when you can't move with the camera. You have to either sit it down somewhere and then walk in front of it and film, or you have to use a gimbal. Like, there's just no way around it. Now, again, I do not have the camera because Sony didn't send it to me. I'm like, what's up with that, Sony? Come on, I thought we were boys. We were homies. But yeah, Sony did not send me this camera, but I watched a bunch of reviews on it, and that is the one thing that everyone says about this camera is the stabilization. And for me personally, I love shooting out and about, so that's the first thing I look for is good stabilization, which is why the Pocket 2 is always in my pocket. The Sony a7S III does a great job of stabilization too, but I do prefer the Pocket 2 stabilization just because it's just good stabilization. And now you can get a lens with OSS in it, like the Sony 10-18mm, but it's still not gonna be that great. I think I'm just spoiled. Like, I just like smooth footage. I don't know. And just looking at the reviews and looking at that footage, it's like unreal to me, because you see these creators holding this camera as steady as possible and it looks like they're doing like that. That's what it looks like. So in my opinion, this would have to be a camera that you sit down and use, or use with a gimbal, which is not a bad thing, because there are some gimbals out there that can handle the size of the Sony ZV-E10 at a really low price. So hope is not lost. Those are my thoughts on the Sony ZV-E10. What are your thoughts on the camera? Do you think it's a waste of money? Do you think it is the perfect vlogging camera? Leave a comment down below, let me know. For me personally, this would have been the best vlogging camera if the stabilization wasn't so bad. Sony has finally started giving us amazing flip-out screens. Now we just need stabilization. Like, just fix the stabilization and we are good, pimpin', we good. But yeah, that is it, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. And if you did, hit that like button, because again, it is really important and it helps out the channel a lot. And also, if you are new, if this is your first time to the channel, hit that subscribe button, because you are officially a ninja boss. So hit that subscribe button. Until then, guys, I'll see you in the next one. I have to go get ready for my flight. But if you want some more of this face, then check out some more of these videos. All right, I gotta run. I gotta get on the flight. I'll catch you guys in the next one.